Good morning. I'm 김남곤, the professor at 동덕 위민 University. The title of this paper is Merger and Acquisition in the Entertainment and Media Industry. Contents, introduction, literature review, empirical analysis, conclusion. Merger and acquisition, M&A, can be broadly defined as a consolidation of two enterprises. Merger usually refers to a full combination of two companies into one organization, while acquisition occurs when one company purchases another company, but the legal dependence of acquired company remains due to the synergy effects of M&A activities. The global M&A market has witnessed a considerable amount of deals over the last 2 decades. Figure 1 shows the M&A statistics in terms of number and value worldwide and the Asia-Pacific region, comparing panel A and panel B. A more profound increase of M&A transactions is observed in the Asia-Pacific region. The number of M&A transactions in the Asia-Pacific region soared from 5,951 in 2002 to 15,772 in 2019, while it increased less than twice worldwide from 72,201 in 2002 to 49,849 in 2009. The entertainment and media industry is undergoing significant change in various aspects such as contents, distribution networks, and revenue-generating business models. Rapidly evolving artificial intelligence technology is changing the entertainment and media landscape drastically and forcing companies to seek alternative ways for creating more firm value to survive in fierce competition. In such a revolutionary wave, M&A has become one of the popular forms of survival strategy. The recent M&A transaction of two entertainment giants, Walt Disney's acquiring what 21st Century Fox in 2017 for $884 billion exemplifies the impulse of the M&A in today's swiftly changing business environment. The private studies investigating the M&A announcement effects on the shareholders' wealth of a bidding firm have been unsuccessful in arriving at a unified result, with the samples consisting of M&A cases occurred in various industries. While their efforts provide quite consistent evidence that shareholders of a target firm enjoy benefits of the integration, since the M&A is considered as a popular strategy that companies rely on to survive in fast-changing business environment, numerous researchers have investigated the impact of M&A on economies. It is widely known that M&A activities have occurred in waves. According to Papadopoulos, economic disturbances give rise to a series of M&A, and there were 7 merger waves between 1895 and 2017. Previous empirical studies concerned with the M&A value creation surrounding M&A deal announcement to the public present quite clear evidence for target firm shareholders. Most studies arrive at the conclusion that M&A activities increase the value of target firm shareholders. Among recent papers, Matti Nobel and Lennebuch show that UK target companies generate positive returns higher than continental European counterparts in both domestic and cross-border M&As. Kronix and Heiberg also report positive evidence returns for target firm shareholders. Comparing to the consistent empirical result concerning the wealth effect of target firms, finding for abnormal returns of bidding firms are less certain. Kronix and Heimbert argue that bidding firms in continental European enjoy positive abnormal return of 0.65%. Matthew concluded that shareholders in acquiring firm benefit of the integration regardless of the location. These findings are in line with the result in Dambolt and Makib and Matib and Ananov. Analyzing the Malaysia market, Isa and Lee report positive stock price reaction of bidders. In a more detailed test, Stocks and We argue that foreign acquiring firms shareholders are more likely to benefit from complying more with the regulation of the target firm's home country. Chen Yun aim to study the politics and strategy for K-pop in France, where is a new market for Korean Wave. For this purpose, they had interviewed French experts in related industry. Zhu and Sim tried to find contributing factors for K-pop's success. They look into how the media improvement has influenced the globalization of popular culture. Kwon and Kim investigate the endeavor of the Korean government to promote Korean cultural industries over the 2 decades. In early 1990s, the Korean government shifted their strategy in cultural industries from political control to viewing them as a key to exportation item. Further North Core shows the conflicts stemming from the transnationalism of South Korea celebrities following the Korean wave in the 21st century. Park and Moon also examined the Korean wave that has grabbed the attention of international media and numerous scholars. Colandro examined the acquisition of Marvel Entertainment by the Walt Disney in 2009, $4 billion acquisition to assess the value and risk of this huge deal. Yangang Kim investigate cross-border M&A by Chinese media and entertainment companies targeting US and Korean companies. As a result, they provide evidence suggesting a negative adverse effect of cross-border M&A deals on Chinese firms operating in the E&M industry. JA provides a framework that links cultural difference with the M&A performance by virtue of psychological safety of employees of acquired firms. He examined the mechanism of cultural difference on M&A performance and figures out the psychological safety play mediating role and leadership visibility plays moderating role respectively. Table 1 presents recent financial performance of four giant entertainment management companies in South Korea: JYP Entertainment, SM Entertainment, YG, and Big Hit. In 2018, Big Hit accumulated 214.2 billion won in revenue, along with 64.1 billion won and 50.2 billion won in operating profit and net income, respectively, compared to compared to 2016, these numbers show more than sixfold increases in revenue, EBIT, and net income. Figure 2 compares revenue and EBIT between SM Entertainment and Big Hit. We can observe the radical growth of Big Hit from 2016 to 2018. This is mainly driven by BTS worldwide mega success that other Korean domestic artists have never been before. SM Entertainment has already completed a few important M&As. Recently, in 2018, it announced the purchase of KIIST Entertainment and FNC Culture, prominent labels focused mainly on acting and media production, respectively. SM Entertainment announced it's planning to take over 25.12% stakes in KIIST, owned by Baekhyun-jun, a former popular Korean actor, at 50 billion won, splitting the deal between cash and stock shares. Our sample consists of M&A announcements in the entertainment and media industry in Korea between January 2000 and December 2019. Most of the previous literature examining changes in firm value around M&A announcements makes use of event study methodology to assess stock price movements of target and acquiring firms using abnormal return and cumulative abnormal return. For the robustness, we adopt two event study methodology using different benchmarks for the normal rate of return, the capital asset pricing model, adjusted model, and the market adjusted model in event study 1 and event study 2 respectively. this is the equation of abnormal return and CAR. Average abnormal return and cumulative abnormal return can be obtained by calculate the average of abnormal returns and cumulative abnormal returns across firms respectively. Figure 3 plots the ARs and CARs in period from 20 days before M&A announcement to 10 days after the event. The graphs in panel A reveal significant positive AR and CAR on day 0 and day 1. In addition, no return reversal in the CAR is observed up to 10 days after the announcement. These results indicate the acquiring firm's shareholders' wealth in the E&M market has increased due to the creation of the bidding firm's intrinsic value. Table 3 provides observation of AAR and CAR on daily basis in detail. Further, the T values of AAR during the pre-announcement effect. This indicates that information leakage does not occur with respect to M&A deals, therefore supporting the semi-strong firm efficient market hypothesis in the Korean E&M market. The CAR declined from day 3 to day 5, indicating that the investors overreact for the first few days immediately after the announcement. As a next step, we analyze which factors related with the stock price response on the M&A announcement in the E&M industry. Table 4 refers to the result of the test. Unlike the prior literature, using the data embracing various industries, you cannot find supportive evidence that acquiring firms' characteristics, except leverage, have any influence on the CAR along the announcement day. Firms with large debt associated with statistically significantly lower CARs. This indicates that a higher level of leverage destroys the shareholder wealth of a bidding firm. Other factors known for contributing the CAR's growth rate of sales that measure a firm's growth and ROE that measures a firm's profitability do not seem to have any relation with the price movement. Thank you for your listening.